Concepts can be viewed from opposing ontological and epistemological perspectives. Concept analysis enables concept development, knowledge enhancement, and use in research or clinical practice. Among the various types of concept analysis, there are two dominant approaches: Walker and Avant's traditional approach and Rodgers' evolutionary method. Although philosophically different, both methods aim to clarify concepts and identify their attributes. Adapted from Wilson's method, Walker and Avant's traditional approach to concept analysis is founded on realism. Concepts are therefore viewed as static entities, independent of context, with clear and distinct boundaries. Linear steps are used to construct cases, and rigid boundaries define the truth of a concept. In this approach, deductive analysis results in a definition of the concept that can be assessed empirically. Examples of concepts that have been defined using this method include inner strength, pain, and power. Modified from Walker and Avant's approach, Rodgers' evolutionary method is founded on relativism. Cyclical phases influenced by significance, use, and application of a concept are employed, and a model case is identified. Concepts are viewed within their context as dynamic and evolving phenomena without identifiable boundaries. Identified meanings change over time. In this approach, attention is given to methodological rigor and concepts are developed through inductive analysis. Examples of concepts that have been described using Rodgers' method include human suffering, health promotion, comfort, and grief. These and other methods have been combined in the process of concept analysis. For example, a combination of methods has been used to analyze the concepts of need, trust, and family-centered care. Regardless of the strategies used, researchers should be aware of the philosophical underpinnings of concept analysis methods and their implications. Do you think that concepts evolve or not? How does your view change how you interact with people? For more about the importance of concepts or ontology, please visit one of the videos on your screen. I read and appreciate all your comments, so let me know what you think with a comment or by liking the video. To stay up to date with new videos as they are released, you can also subscribe. Thank you.